Hello everyone. Welcome to the 17th video of the Adobe After Effects tutorial from beginner to advanced. If you want to learn the After Effects software completely, please subscribe to my channel. In this video, I teach different ways to create a mask. In After Effects, a mask is often a shape that reveals or conceals a particular region of a layer in your composition. You can use masking to hide or reveal a portion of a layer or an object. To create a mask, we must first select the layer and then create a mask with the shape tool. If you do not select the layer, a shape layer will be created instead of the mask. So I delete the shape layer and select this video layer to create a mask. Now I select the shape tool and create a mask by dragging the mouse. You can choose any shape. If you hold the shift button while dragging, the mask will be created in the form of a circle. If you hold down the control button while dragging, the mask shape will be created from the center point. And if you hold the alt button and drag, the edges will show the new size of the mask, and after releasing the alt button, the size of the mask will change. After creating the mask, we can only view the part of the video that is inside the mask. Also, mask 1 will be created under the layer we selected. To move the mask in the composition panel, first select mask 1, and then drag with the selection tool on the edge of the mask with a left click. But if I select the video layer and drag it again, the video and the mask move at the same time. So by turning off the mask, you will see that the location of the video has changed. I hit Ctrl plus Z a few times to go back. If I select the main layer and drag it from the corners, I can change the shape of the mask and the layer at the same time. But by selecting a mask and double-clicking on these points, only the shape of the mask changes. We can also change the size of the mask from the edges. If needed, we can create many masks in each layer. So I select the layer and create other masks with the shape tool. In this way, masks 2 and 3 are created, and we can only view the video from inside the masks. I remove mask 2 and 3. In front of each mask we create, there are add and inverted options. When we activate the inverted button, the effect of the mask is reversed. In fact, now we can only see the part of the video that is outside the circle, and we cannot see the inside of the mask. If I enable the None option, the mask is still there, but the mask no longer affects the layer. By selecting the Add option, the mask will be activated again. The Subtract option has the same effect as the inverted option on the mask and reverses the effect of the mask. There are other options, but to see their performance, we need to create another mask. I select the Add option for this mask. I put another video under this layer. It is clear that only the part inside the mask can be seen from the top layer. By activating the inverted button, the mask will be inverted, and we will see the layer below inside the mask. I select the top layer and add another mask with the shape tool. I disable the inverted option. In this way, we have two layers of masks, where parts of both masks are placed on top of each other. Now we want to see the effect of the masks on each other. I activate the inverted option for mask 2. In this case, we only see part of the image of the bottom layer inside mask 2, and it seems that even mask 1 is masked. It may be a bit confusing, but if you practice you will definitely learn. Remember that masks only affect the layer itself and below, not the layers above. This time, instead of the Add option, I choose the Intersect option. In this case, the common part of mask 1 and 2 remains and displays a part of the upper layer video. By choosing other options, you can see their effect on the layer and masks. By selecting the difference option, the common and outer parts of the masks will display the bottom layer. By activating the inverted option, everything will be inverted again, and the none option will also remove the effect of the mask on the layer. For mask 1, if I activate the inverted option, you can see that layer and mask 2 are masked at the same time. Now I remove mask 2. I go into mask settings 1 and select the selection tool. In mask settings, the first option is mask path, which is used to animate the mask. At frame 0, I create a keyframe for the mask path, and by holding the left click on the edge of the mask, I change the location of the mask. Now I move the time pointer forward a bit and change the mask location again. Make sure that the mask is selected. If I press the play button, I can see the movement of the mask. In order for the mask to move a little more slowly, I increase the distance between the keyframes. I remove these keyframes and replace the mask in the middle of the composition. Also, by double-clicking on the edge of the composition, we can change the shape of the mask by moving the levers. By changing the mask expansion option, the amount of mask expansion changes. I will create 2 keyframes for that so you can see its use. Also, by changing the mask opacity option, the mask transparency value changes. And finally, by changing the value of the mask feather option, the sharpness of the edges of the mask fades. If I deselect a layer, we can better see the feather changes on the edge of the mask. Now I remove the mask and the top layer and create a solid. Solid is a simple single color layer whose color can be changed. To create a solid, right-click in the empty space of the timeline and select the solid option from the new section. You can also select the solid option from the layer menu. In the solid window, I change the name of the solid to blue. We can change the size of the solid, the unit of measurement, and the color of the solid. To make the solid size equal to the composition size, click on the Make Comp Size option. I change the color of the solid to blue and click on OK. In this way, a solid is created. I place the solid below the video layer and select the video layer. I create a mask with the shape tool and press the play button. This way, we only see the video inside the mask, and the solid is placed above and below the video. I remove this mask and select the video layer again. I select the ellipse tool and by holding the control button and double-clicking on the ellipse tool, this mask will be created. I press the play button. In this way, an interesting mask is created. We can also create a mask with the pen tool, provided that we create a closed shape. In the next lesson, I will teach how to work with the pen tool, but in this video I wanted you to know that you can also create a mask with the pen tool. You can lock the mask to prevent it from moving unintentionally. Okay guys, thank you very much for watching this tutorial till the end. Please like the video and leave a comment for me. Subscribe to see more tutorials. I see you next time.